Are you fed up with paying ridiculous prices for a burger that you can actually make yourself quite easily, but you're not really sure how to make a burger? Well, I'm going to show you how to make a burger. All you need is some mince. You don't really need the onion, but I like it. Some salt. You absolutely need salt. If you think you can make a tasty burger without salt, get nothing coming. You might use black pepper if you like that sort of thing. I'm not so bothered myself. Grater is optional, but I think it's a good way of dealing with the onion. So, let's get started. A mixing bowl is useful. You can probably just do it directly on the table, but it'll make a bit of a mess. You can't be screaming of getting stuff in your hands, which obviously I have washed beforehand. This is an IKEA grater, but I'm not advertising IKEA in particular.
That was me.
And then all I'm going to do is just peel off some of this skin. Again, I haven't even got a kitchen knife with me. Oh, the other thing is don't throw the onion skin away. Because you can dye your clothes with that. I might do that in a future episode. Right. That sort of peeled it up from way enough. The little trick here is to rotate the onion as you grate. It tends to prevent the sort of long screw bits. Sorry about the noises I'm off as well. There's a rowdy lot around here, you know. It's at the maker's space, so what do you expect? You should put it down in time. That'll do. Look at that loveliness. And the juice, it's probably how juicy it is. It's always a joy to edit, isn't it? And then you just get stuck in. Then you get your noisy assistant to grind the salt in.
Michael?
Come on, Michael. Make yourself useful.
I'm going to go Tesco and get some bits.
Loads of it. Just keep going mad. Yeah, you need more salt than you can imagine.
Put Marmite in.
You could do that.
That'd be nice, actually.
Yeah, in fact, that's an interesting area, spicing, you know, things like paprika, that's a good one. And you're getting curry powder, if you like that sort of thing.
Well,
I actually really like the taste of the meat, so...
I'm just going to retrieve my car before Andy says
that. Right, yeah. So yeah, you can add various spicing if you want. Paprika's very good. To be honest, anything you like. But you'll find that is all you need. Plenty of salt, an onion, bit of meat. It's, and again, it's no more precise than that. And then I think to get the best flavour, I tend to just leave that for a little while. In the fridge. Room temperature is alright as long as you're going to be quick about it. If you're, you know, if you're doing it in the morning, say you're going to have a barbecue in the afternoon, then leave it in the fridge. You just let the sort of onion juice seep into the meat. But that's basically it. And you're like, well, that doesn't look much like a burger yet. Well, all you've got to do is get a bit, roll it in your hands. I tend to find that if you roll it into a ball first, you get it so that it's all kind of one bit and it's sort of, you know, it's all stuck together, and then just flatten it and you can have your burgers whatever size you like. So if you're crafty and you're making a burger and you're running the barbecue, you can have a massive burger yourself and give your family little small ones like this. And you get it all over your hands, but don't worry about it.
Oh,
but basically, I've put good weapons.
If you're about that big, but you're putting 20 euros and get out 20 plastic coins, so basically, you're putting 20 euros and get a massive pound of coins. And if you think that in the world,
What?
What's he got now?
Number three.
Oh,
Danny's
leg.
What the fuck's wrong with this
yard? That one's yours.
Is this health and safety or what?